Welcome to the second lesson in our series of training videos. This lesson will discuss the company maintenance screen and entering your company's information. You will be prompted to enter your email address the first time you start GroundsKeeper Pro. Your email address is needed to utilize the software's emailing functions. To continue entering your company information, click the Company Maintenance button from the main menu to access the screen. The purpose of the company maintenance screen is to store information about your company. The software utilizes this information in many of the software functions. The demo data that you see here is loaded anytime the software is installed. Type in your company name on company line 1. Simply delete or highlight and replace each field with your company information. If your company name is too long to fit on the line, you can utilize company line 2 as shown in this illustration. You can also use line 2 as an attention line if needed. The company address line is the address your customers will send their payments to and is printed on the invoice's return payment stub as well as the return address. This address is also the registered user's address of record, which is used to license the software. If you are using a P.O. box for your business mail, you may want to use it here. Fill in the remainder city, state, and zip. The zip or postal code will accept up to 10 alphanumeric characters. The Make Checks Payable To field is printed on all invoices, directing your customers how to compose their check payments to you. Your regular hourly rate is the default amount used when charging for labor. However, different hourly rates can be used when generating estimates, contracts, and time and materials. The average employee rate is the default amount used to calculate profitability when creating an estimate. Both of these default settings are discussed in other training videos. If you have a website, enter your website address here. Your email address is pre-filled with the data you entered earlier. Your company phone number is the published phone number your customers will contact you with. This number is also the registered user's phone number of record, which is used to license the software. You can add up to 3 additional phone numbers below, but be aware these numbers will be published on your invoices. Therefore, do not enter any phone numbers here that you do not want your customers to call you on. The additional phone numbers are not required by the software. You can set a password here by selecting the Use Password option and then entering a password. The password set here will lock out the entire system. You may want to password protect just the sensitive data screens like the income statistics or payroll screens. If this is the case, do not enter a password here. Some municipalities require a contractor's or certification number to be printed on a customer's invoice. Enter that number here. Let's take a look at where your company information is printed on an invoice. Our invoices are designed to use double window envelopes. Looking at the top of part 1 of the invoice, notice your company name and address is printed in the top left. This location is the return address area. Your company phone numbers are printed here, your license or certification number, and your website and email address. Moving down to part 3, we see the detachable return payment stub. Your customer returns this section with their check or credit card payment. Your company address is printed in the Mail To area, and the Make Check Payable To is printed here. If you are using our pre-printed invoice forms, the text here will read Tear on Dotted Line instead of Cut on Dotted Line. The reason being, our pre-printed forms are perforated for easy separation of the payment stub. This is preferable than having to cut with scissors as with printing on plain paper. Plus, you will save over 60% on your invoicing costs for replacement ink cartridges. As you can see, our pre-printed forms already have printed 90% of the ink you would normally use if you were printing on plain paper. Your printer only needs to fill in the data. With a high cost of replacement ink cartridges, this will save you up to 14 cents per invoice.
Wow!
Plus, the invoices print four times faster. It just makes sense to use our invoice forms, but the choice is yours. To watch a short video about our invoice forms and window envelopes, click the Tutorials button from the main menu and scroll to the video titled AdCAD's Billing System in Action. As mentioned earlier, our invoice forms are designed to use double window envelopes, providing a professional look to your invoicing. Let's take a look at the invoice using a number 9 double window envelope. This envelope is used to mail the invoice to your customer. As you can see, the invoice mail to and return address information lines up perfectly in the windows. The payment return stub is compatible with a number 8 double window check return envelope. You can include this envelope with your mailing for your customer's convenience. This envelope eliminates your customers from having to address an envelope by hand. The number 8 check return envelope is slightly smaller so that it easily inserts inside the number 9 shipping envelope along with the invoice. GroundsKeeper Pro is also capable of printing your company logo if you have one. Having a logo is not required, but if desired, can be created and purchased from our website. The logo could be placed on the right side of the invoice as shown here, or on the left side as shown here. Your logo will appear through the return address window of the number 9 envelope when using the left side option. We have a separate video that discusses logos. Click the Tutorials button from the main menu and scroll to the video titled Adding Your Company Logo. This completes the Entering Your Company Information video. The next video in our series of training videos is titled Setting Up Your Email Account.